G'day, g'day, it's Thomas here from Thomas PC Guru Engines. It's another bloody gorgeous day here in Christchurch, New Zealand. Actually, it is paradise today. It is incredibly bloody gorgeous day for the, you know, late winter. I'm going to run these two engines, which I believe I have rehabilitated from their difficult form into running really well. So this is petrol, pump gas, with a bit of two-stroke oil. These engines have been run plenty of times, so not as much oil as I used to run through them, which used to get them pretty dirty. Maybe I should clean the spark plugs before I start. Oh, I'd better do that. Now, easy to get off on both these engines, like really easy to get off. Where's my little... No, can't use this. Okay. Ooh, okay. It's not bad. I'm going to give it a wee squirt. Carb cleaner. Yep, that's definitely better. That's like new. Okay, I'll poke that in there. Oh, we got over spillage. Oh, well, a bit late to see that, wasn't I? Where's my rag? Okay, it's got a rubber ring on that one. Don't ask me why. This one here, it's got a bigger tank for some. Well, it's not much bigger engine, capacity-wise. It's really not. I think one of them is. I think this might be 1.6, and this is 2.2, something like that, 2.3. Seagulls is squawk out there. Also pretty good, but we'll still give it a clean. That's still got the copper washer that I prefer. For some reason that's running one of the new rubber washers on the spark plug. So both of these have got the little lever to show me where the right place is on the... Actually, this one hasn't. Okay, so I've put a new carb on that one. Interesting. So among the many things that I tried to get when I was trying to get this one working again, a new carb was part of what I did. It wasn't the carb, incidentally, but I had screwed the carb up a bit with trying to get it to go in my desperation. Now, if you haven't run these engines for a while, one of the things that can play up is the intake valve. Believe it or not, the intake valve needs to be really freed, and that can just get hit with a bit of oil. Oil can dry out in it and it can just stop the engine running, and that's what the problem was on this one. Just gonna blow the rest of that through. Okay. Right, we shall see what we shall see with these. Okay, we've got lots of batteries here, but they are old, so we better check them. Plus. Plus 1.5, okay, that'll do. Right, I'm just going to clean those. Clean those intake valves a bit. Thank you.
was the engine trying to start. Come on.
One eternity later.
It's not making as much power as I want. Okay, now the diesel engine is still in final testing. It's assembled, it's in final testing. My supplier says it should be on its way soon. So that's been a bit of a wait. That's the difficulty of getting an injector working in a tiny space like that, in a model engine. Very difficult. So I'm still excited about that. If anybody has any news of Matt from Steam212, he hasn't posted for 4 months. I'd love to know if he's okay, really. That's just what I want to know. Is the guy okay? What's the story? Would be lovely as well. Hope you guys are getting the kind of bloody gorgeous weather that I'm getting here. You're safe and well. This is a goodbye from me. Until next time.